Hello and welcome to CBS Institute. Welcome to Current Affairs session. In this video, we shall be discussing some of the recent important current affairs. These are very important from the point of view of upcoming exams. Now watch the video completely and do not forget to prepare your own notes. Now let us begin our session with the first one. See, World Press Freedom Index 2021 has been released. This becomes very important from the point of view of all the upcoming exams. See, assume this situation, this is country X and this is country Y. Now for example, the media in this country has criticized the government. In turn, the government of this particular country has punished the media personnel here. Okay. Now for example, media in this country also criticized the government. The government of this particular country did not take any punishment. In fact, it let the media go in its own way. So from this example, it is clear that there is no press freedom in this country and there is press freedom in the country Y. See, on these lines, every year an index is released that is called World Press Freedom Index. Okay. So for the year 2021, the World Press Freedom Index has been released. See, every year, the Paris-based non-governmental organization called Reporters Without Borders, every year releases World Press Freedom Index. World Press Freedom Index is released by Reporters Without Borders, a Paris-based non-governmental organization. Okay, so in this edition, that is World Press Freedom Index 2021, it considered 180 countries. So it evaluated the press freedom liberty in the countries 180. Okay, 180 countries were considered. So out of 180 countries, the first rank was awarded to the country Norway. First ranked country is Norway. Second rank has been awarded to the country Finland. Okay. Finland. See, whenever you come across any index or indices, you must know the first ranked country and also very important is India's rank. Okay. So India's rank is very important where we are in this world. Okay. As far as World Press Freedom Index is concerned. Okay. See, out of 180 countries, India has been ranked at 142nd place. 142nd place. Which means in the country Norway, there is more press freedom. Okay, there is more press freedom. So out of 180, our rank is 142nd. Even in the year 2020 World Press Freedom Index also, our rank was same. That was 142nd. Okay, see, the last country is not important, but from the point of view of knowledge. Okay, so this becomes important only from the point of view of knowledge. Okay, so the Eritrea has been ranked at 180th position, 180. Okay, so these points are very important from the point of view of upcoming exams. See, if any report or indices comes into news, you have to know first ranked country and also India's position in that particular index or report. Okay, see, if the questions were to be raised as far as World Press Freedom Index is concerned, then the questions could be, which of the following organizations release World Press Freedom Index? This could be a question. So the answer becomes Reporters Without Borders, or Reporters Without Borders has released World Press Freedom Index 2021. Where is the location? Where are the headquarters of this particular NGO? Could also be a question. Okay, so recently World Press Freedom Index 2021 has been released. Which of the following countries has got first rank? This could be a question in our exam. Okay, first ranked country is Norway. So India's position is 142nd. Okay, so these are the important points. You have to note down all these points. Now let's take up the next one. See, recently the Minister for Industry and Trade, Piyush Goyal, has launched a scheme called Startup India Seed Fund Scheme. Okay, so seed fund is the fund which is required at the start of the business, at the initial stage of the business is called seed fund. Okay, see, Startup India Seed Fund Scheme has been launched by Minister Piyush Goyal. Okay, see, the main objective of this Startup India Seed Fund Scheme is to provide financial assistance, okay, loan assistance, financial assistance for the startups, newly established companies. See, the total corpus, the total amount of the fund is 945 crore. See, this fund duration, okay, the financial assistance will be provided during the period between the financial year 2021-22 and 2024-25. So during these 4 years, the financial assistance out of this fund will be provided to startups. Okay, so duration, the term of the scheme is 4 years. The term of the scheme is 4 years from the financial year 2021-22 to 2024-25. So there could be a questions in our exams. Startup India Seed Fund Scheme has been launched by who among the following ministers? Then answer becomes Piyush Goyal. What is the total amount of the fund allocated to the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme? So this is 945 crore rupees. Okay, what is the duration? What is the term of the Startup India Seed Fund Scheme? This could also be a question in our exam. Okay, see, the startups, newly established companies, will be selected by an expert advisory committee created by Department for Promotion and Industry. This is called Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. This is DPIIT stands for Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. See, an expert advisory committee has been created by DPIIT, and this expert advisory committee will select the startups which will get finance from this fund. Okay, so these are the important points with respect to this issue. Now let us take up the next one. The State of Global Climate Report 2020 has been released. See, World Meteorological Organization. This organization was established on 23rd March 1961. This is headquartered at Geneva, Switzerland. The president of this organization is Gerhard Adrian. See, every year, World Meteorological Organization releases State of the Global Climate Report. See, for the year 2020, the World Meteorological Organization, the report has been released. Okay, see, whenever an index or report comes into news, you have to know important points. If there are rankings, you have to know first ranked country and also India's position. Okay, if there are no ranks in the report, some of the important points are to be kept in mind. Okay, as far as this report is concerned, okay, there could be a question. State of Global Climate Report is released by, okay, World Meteorological Organization. Okay, see, some of the important points with respect to State of the Global Climate Report 2020 are, see, the report said that cyclone which occurred in May 2020, the name of the cyclone was Amphan. The name of the cyclone was Amphan, which affected India as well as Bangladesh. See, the report said that the cyclone Amphan was the costliest cyclone, which means It caused huge economic loss to the planet. If we convert it into the monetary value, the report said that it cost $14 billion, $14 billion loss to the planet. If we convert it into Indian rupees, it is 1.5 lakh crore rupees. 1.5 lakh crore rupees. So the cyclone Amphan caused 1.5 lakh crore economic loss to the planet. Okay, so the report also said that 2020, the year 2020, was one of the three warmest years on record. One of the three warmest years, because temperatures are gradually increasing because of climate change. So 2020, the year, also saw increased temperature. Okay, so this is one of the three warmest years on record. See, according to report, the warmest year is 2016. The first warmest year is 2016. The second ranked year is 2020, and third one is 2019. Third warmest year is 2019. See, this is very important from the point of view of upcoming exams. See, World Meteorological Organization was established on 23rd March. So every year, 23rd March is observed as World Meteorological Day. World Meteorological Day is observed on 23rd March. See, this year, that is 2021, World Meteorological Day theme was, World Meteorological Day theme was, the ocean, our climate, the ocean, our climate and weather, our climate and weather. This is the theme of World Meteorological Day 2021. So these are the important points with respect to this State of Global Climate Report 2020. Okay, now note down all these important points. Now let us take up the next one, another report, Global Energy Review Report 2021. See, Global Energy Review Report is released by International Energy Agency. International Energy Agency. See, this International Energy Agency is located at Paris, France, and Fatih Birol is the chief of International Energy Agency. See, every year this agency or organization releases Global Energy Review Report. So for the year 2021, it has been released. See, some of the important points with respect to this Global Energy Review are, the report said that global carbon dioxide CO2 emissions are set to touch 33 billion tons in the year 2021. This is important points. See, technical knowledge of 33 billion tons, okay. So what is carbon dioxide? These technical terms are not important, but what report said is important. Okay, so the report said that CO2 emissions in the year 2021 will reach, okay, 33 billion tons. Okay, so compared to the levels in 2022, this is, the 33 billion tons is 5%, okay, 5% higher than the levels of 2022. Okay, so this point is very important from the point of view of exam. There could be a question, according to Global Energy Review 2021, the global emissions space are expected to touch space by the year 2021. Okay, so in the year 2021, so the space we have to fill, this is 33 billion tons. Otherwise, Global Energy Review report is released by, this could also be a question, that is International Energy Agency. So these are the important points with respect to Global Energy Review 2021. Now let us take up the next one. World Voice Day. World Voice Day is observed on 16th April every year. April 16th every year. So this year, that is 2021, theme is One World. One World, Many Voices. One World, Many Voices. So these are the important articles. With this, I conclude the session. Thank you for watching.